thing that they were trying to write.
What's good, what's good, what's good? What's good, what's good? What's going on, what's going on? I'm gonna let most people get in before we really get into it. You know what I'm saying? It's my little docket here. You know what I'm saying? It's my notes. Just a little Kevin Samuels to get y'all started. You know what I'm saying? Piss off the feminists. My wife can't stand Kevin Samuels. Shout out to my wife, by the way. Shout out to Octavia Singletary. I told her I was about to do a live video for my podcast, and she actually laughed at me. You know what I'm saying? She don't take my podcast serious. She don't take my dreams serious. So y'all make sure y'all get somebody and find somebody that support your dreams. You know what I'm saying? But shout out to my wife. You know what I'm saying? She thought it was funny. This is my dreams right here. This is my business. This is my brand. I'm trying to build a brand. You know what I'm saying? I'm trying to build a brand. But anyways, let's get back to it. So, shout out to Kevin Samuels too. As I said, he pisses off the feminists. Love that guy. He go a little overboard sometimes, but ultimately I do believe, as I said on my last episode with my little sister Shania, he ultimately makes a lot of good points that pisses people off because they're used to being lied to. And that's a problem with social media in general. A lot of people get lied to, and it's so against the norm that they're used to when they hear the truth, or just something that's against what they're used to hearing. Social media bridges that gap in ways that we never seen before. So that's something that I feel is dope. You can take it as a gift and a curse, but yeah. But anyways, let's get into this. What's good, what's good, what's good, what's good? This is A Penny for Your Thoughts, episode 5. I'm your boy, Verdell Singletary. Definitely gonna throw this on the YouTube after we're done shooting it. That is at Young DTV. That is my YouTube. That's my brand. That's my movement. That's my production. You know, get with it or get lost, as Wayne said. It's a major movement. So first thing I want to talk about is I shot 3 episodes over the last few weeks of A Penny for Your Thoughts podcast, and I wanted to give a quick shout out to my guests. I have my boy Two Broads on here. He actually just shot a video to his new song, and so that's out right now. Check out his new music video. Excuse me for a second, y'all. This is very unprofessional of me. I can't give my man a shout out and not know his song, so we're gonna look it up. Shout out to my boy Two Broads. Okay. Shout out to my boy Two Broads. His new single is Like the Rest. His new music video is out right now. Also, shout out to my brother Maine. He was my second guest. We chopped it up with him, talked about his new plans and visions for gospel music. You know, his endeavors, upcoming project that he got coming out this summer. I'm actually going to be on that, by the way. So shout out to my brother Maine. His new single is The Takeover. Then also, final shout out to my sister, Naya Marie Singletary. You can check her out on Facebook. And then also, stage name is Sauce the Artist, obviously. She might get mad at me that I gave up her government. But Sauce the Artist, she got her song. It's called Company. And I love that song. It's definitely a bop. Check that out. That was on episode 4 of A Penny for Your Podcast. And right now, this is episode 5. So let's get into it. One thing I want to talk about is my platform, A Penny for Your Thoughts. I want to give y'all a quick breakdown of what this is. So for me, I wanted a platform where artists from Buffalo could come to. Pretty much, you see things like obviously all the radio shows across the country, but in particular the ones in New York City, like Hot 97 or the Breakfast Club. When artists go through on their promo runs, that's like a stop that they have to make. I wanted to build a platform like that for artists in Buffalo, local artists. Like, if they got a new product, something that they're promoting, they can come through and stop. But it's not just for artists. I know I say artists and producers or anybody in the music. That's my first love. That's my first passion. It's going to always be, because I was an artist first. So I'm thinking like an artist. But also, there's other things I would like to have on. I would like to have politicians. I would like to have preachers. Definitely preachers of the gospel. I would like to have anybody that wants to be on there, blue-collar workers, professionals. I'm going to have my brother on here, hopefully, next week, my brother Vincent. He's going to talk about what it's like being a firefighter. You know what I'm saying? I'm a correction officer myself, so I'm going to have stories in the future to share with you guys, talking about prison, what it's like working in a correctional facility in New York State. My wife, she's a school teacher. She's going to be on here. My mother's also a school teacher. My father, he's a preacher. He's going to be on here. So this platform is for everybody. A Penny for Your Thoughts. It's not just for people in the music. You don't have to be into that. You know, anybody that's doing something productive, they can come on here and have a chat. You know what I'm saying? And like I said, it's a Penny for Your Thoughts. It's a place where you can share your two cents. So that's pretty much what this is about. Once again, we'd love to give a shout out to my prior guests, because they're giving people a taste of what it's like to come on here. You know what I'm saying? They haven't been on here before. Nobody's seen what A Penny for Your Thoughts is like. So my guests kind of serve as like an incubator, if you will, a sort of experiment, so people can see where it is that I'm trying to go with this show, because I really want to take this far. I take this very seriously. This is like my baby right here. This is like an idea that I was able to transform for just something in my head as my imagination. So now this is something physical that you can actually see. You know what I'm saying? Anyways, that's what this is. This is A Penny for Your Thoughts. This is a platform for everybody to be able to get on and share their two cents. So that's pretty much where we're going with this. Moving forward, let's get into it. Another thing that I'm shooting, I have not given up on my series Bible Study with V. That's going to be coming back. I plan on shooting my next episode tomorrow. I believe the last one I left up on was episode 7, so it was Genesis chapter 7. Next, we're going to go into Genesis chapter 8 tomorrow. So we're going to go into the next chapter of Genesis as we continue to study the Bible. Study the word of God, you know what I'm saying, and get an understanding for ourselves of what that word means, because once again, what that was all about was many people look at the Bible as something very complex, possibly difficult to get into, and so I wanted to make it simple for, you know, the average Joe to understand what the Bible is, and you know, I give my perspective of what I'm getting out of the scriptures, and you know, you can check out the Bible too for yourself. And you might not get the same thing as me, but you get a piece of what the Bible is talking about. You know what I'm saying? So it's just from my perspective. So Bible Study with V. Next episode, episode 8 is coming out tomorrow as well. What else we got going on? I want to give a quick shout out to my trainer, Jai Jank. He just got certified as a trainer in New York State. I've been watching this man's fitness journey, and it inspired me, motivated me. I seen him lose a bunch of weight and then put on a bunch of muscle. And to see somebody do that almost simultaneously is very impressive for me. That's something I've been trying to do for the last few years. I got a little diesel, I ain't gonna lie. I can't even flex my muscle completely, honestly, because we had our first session on Thursday. It's now Saturday. I'm still very sore. I'm sore as hell from that. So shout out to my trainer, because he's gonna get me right. You know what I'm saying? Hopefully, you know, 3 months from now, we can do a crazy transformation photo shoot or something. I mean, I got like a month before I go back to corrections and go back to working in the prisons. So over this month, I'll definitely show y'all some transformation photos. But I know right now, my muscles are very sore. That's crazy. We already 10 minutes into this. So let's keep it moving. Let's keep it moving along. But shout out to my trainer, Jai Jank, once again. I just shared a post of his flyer. Y'all definitely, if y'all trying to get fit, trying to get in shape, y'all check my man's out, you know what I'm saying? Schedule some sessions with him, you know what I'm saying? It's $125 for 6 sessions. I think that price is very solid. So y'all definitely tap in with my bro, Jai Jank, for physical training. Keeping it moving. Y'all know I had to go to the old school hip-hop beats, you know what I'm saying? Everything with me is all 90s. I'm a 90s baby. It's either 90s R&B or 90s hip hop for me, so it's pretty much what it is, you know what I'm saying? From the 99 to the 2000s, we keep it lit, you know what I'm saying? A Penny for Your Thoughts podcast. So, next thing I want to talk about, we're actually going to switch gears right now. So, something that I wanted to talk about was my favorite song of the week right now, right? So, I've been listening to this newer artist. I'm not going to say completely new. The first time I heard of this guy, his name is Giveon. I don't know where he's from, but the first time I heard of him was actually on a Drake record, Chicago Freestyle, and he was singing on a hook of that joint. And his voice was very different. I honestly thought he was this guy, Sampha, from, he does a couple of records with Drake, but it's a completely different dude, but I love his voice because it's so different. And he has somewhat of a lower range, but he has a pretty nice falsetto too. But he has this song called Heartbreak Anniversary. And there's like a challenge going on to it now, you know, a TikTok challenge with a whole, it's a whole dance and everything to it. But, yo, let's just get into this record. So this is my favorite song of the week. And I'm going to do this every week on my podcast. It's something I'm going to add. But, yo, he's on fire. Let's just get into this. Let's just get into this. I'm going to shut up. Let's turn it up. On your side of the bed,
still got your things here. They're staring at me like souvenir. Don't wanna let you off my head. Just like the day that I met you, the day I thought forever. I said that you love me, but that'll last whenever. It's cold outside, like when you walked out my life. Why you walk out my life? Your life is everything. All these days I feel like me. Every kind of person, me. Cause I remember every time. All these days I feel like you need me. I'm breaking it back. Do you want to be me? I'm building my hopes up like presents unopened to this.
Yeah, so that is a little sneak peek of Giveon's Heartbreak Anniversary. So that song is fire. Y'all definitely check out his album. Check him out as an artist. I think he's actually dating Justine Skye right now. So, but definitely shout out to him. I really like his register, the way that he uses his voice. He has, I think, like an accent to him, but I think he's from America. I don't know where he's from, but I really like his voice, really like his sound, and I love that song, Heartbreak Anniversary, so check it out. All right, so that's my favorite song of the week, but next, I'm going to get into honorable mention. So I'm going to be honest. For the longest, I could not understand the hype about this dude. I remember at one point he was dating Meg Thee Stallion, but now I guess he's with the girl Ari that was with G Herbo. It's Moneybagg Yo, but for the longest I didn't understand what the hype was about him, right? But he got this new song. He actually just said he believes it's the song of the summer, you know what I'm saying? And I can always respect an artist when they toot their own horn, so that makes me listen more. When you really believe in yourself to say something like that and just hop out of left field and, you know, throw yourself out there like that, so I that made me listen. His song with Keisha. Now, honestly, the song is, to me, is obviously about lean. It make it sound like it's about a woman, but it's about lean. And I thought it was about a girl at first, but the song is Jive Fire. So this is my honorable mention, close second place to Heartbreak Anniversary. So this is second place for Song of the Week.
I kind of put the cup down for a minute, but honestly, it ain't nobody.
Let's get into this, you know what I'm saying? Let's just vibe out.
It's your cup. Drinking, so whatever the hell was in my cup, the only reaction I did was got more popular, more successful, did a lot more things than I've ever done. I probably should pick that cup back up.
I'm sitting here looking at Keisha like, do you love me? Do you love me not? Damn, you hit the spot. Taste like candy, sweet like fruit, wet like water. Can I love on you? Withdrawals.
This guy's fired.
Every day I need a dose.
You can't tell me this don't slap.
I got my times when I go ghost. But you know, I'm stepper. Priority status, so them other bitches mad ain't too bad. Coming through 100,000, I spent their times two on you. Call myself, can you lose? Then I pop back up like peekaboo. Girl, I go flyer than most, Louis V. Coke. Gas station, coffee cup full, I don't drive boats. No money came by happiness, but she found love inside of G. Needing something to eat, that's all a thug nigga need. No lie, you get me higher than the prices of my weed. I'm displaying my feelings like I'm wearing them on my sleeves. 1 minute I'm gone, true, the next one I be running back. Throw your way, I go my way, but somehow we be still attached. Trying to find my ounces with this cup, but ain't no truth in that. They be like I'm done for fucking with you, I spend stupid racks. I'm sitting here knowing I don't need you, pour my O's in the lid, sipping, chasing with my reef. Can't get my mind on my keys. Watch me put my heart in this cup. In my feelings, she my therapist. I'ma talk to this cup. I ring around the road. Z cup full of OZs. I hope I don't OD. She keeps saying, "Pull me." Turn me to their purple demon emoji. Down fuck me like you miss me. It's been.
All right, that's enough of that song. So I'll tell y'all what. Excuse me. So I'll tell y'all what. I'm not trying to necessarily promote drug culture. That's not what I'm trying to do. I just think the song is a bop, though. I think the beat fire, and I like the way he rode the beat. Like, his flow is on point. But obviously, like I said, the song is talking about lean. Don't do lean. Don't do lean. But let's keep it moving. Let's keep it moving. So pretty much, oh yeah. So now we're gonna get into sports. We're gonna get into sports. We're gonna talk about basketball. So as you all know, the Lakers took the L in the first round. This is LeBron's first time losing in the playoffs, the first round. And I was very tight as a fan, but at the same time, I understood. Anthony Davis is hurt. LeBron is hurt. And something that I'm annoyed about is people coming at LeBron like the man wasn't hurt. He's playing hurt. The only time LeBron missed the playoffs since his rookie year or got bounced out the first round, the first year with the Lakers and this third year with the Lakers, he was hurt both times. And the man is like past the age of 34, both of these years. Like, he's older. You know what I'm saying? That don't take away from the last 10 years of greatness. This man went to the finals every single season. No, he went 9 out of 10 seasons. Excuse me. This man went to the finals 9 out of 10 seasons. Like, we're not going to give him props for that. Like, to me, Michael Jordan is still the GOAT of all time. And Kobe was very, very close. To me, it goes like this. It's Michael Jordan, then there's LeBron, then there's Kobe. You know what I'm saying? Rest in peace. But as far as the greatest players of all time, I think Kobe is behind LeBron only because LeBron is more efficient than him as far as like, and obviously I'm not the biggest basketball person, so if somebody be like, he don't know what the hell he's talking about, hey, I mean, I watch it as much as I can. I watch ESPN First Take, but when you look at efficiency and numbers and analytics, you get into that. LeBron, sorry, he's the better player. God rest Kobe's soul, because I love Kobe. But I also know Kobe's stats could have been better, obviously, if he didn't have Shaq. But then at the same time, because he fed Shaq a lot, but at the same time, Shaq helped him win those first three rings. So, let's not even get into Kobe, though, because like I almost don't even like talking about him because he's not here no more, because I love Kobe so much. But LeBron, people act like this man, like y'all don't put respect on his name enough. And it really irritates me because LeBron is a whole icon, living legend, still playing out here. Like, he's like Tom Brady on the court. You know what I'm saying? And so the man is hurt. His co-star is Anthony Davis. And Anthony Davis obviously couldn't play. Like, he was messed up. So, for me, it's annoying that the lack of respect there is for King James. You know what I'm saying? But it's all good. Because he won the chip literally back in October. Didn't get no rest. Had to come back and suit up and play in, wasn't it December? Yeah, like right before Christmas. So, he literally had 2 weeks off. I mean, 2 months off. And, or like a month and a half off. Excuse me. Yeah, so because they stopped playing in October. So he had like a month and a half off of rest, had to go right back out, and then got hurt because somebody dove into his leg like an idiot. And so he got hurt, and they got bounced out the first round. So to me, Like, all that stuff is cool, but now my man about to rest up, just like he did his first season in LA. He rested up, got AD, and then they won the chip in the pandemic, in the bubble. He about to do the same thing again. So everybody can keep hating all they want, you know what I'm saying? But the Lakers going to be back next year. Bigger, stronger, healthier. Let's get it. You know what I'm saying? We about to see Space Jam this summer, like he said. And they're going to play this summer and beat the Monstars. And then next year, they're going to come back and beat them Brooklyn Nets. You know what I'm saying? But that being said, now that LeBron and them lost because they was hurt. And I do believe, like, if he would have somehow pulled off beating the Suns, they would have lost next round to the Nuggets. Because they just didn't have it this year. You know what I'm saying? They just didn't have it. Props to them for giving a valiant effort. But they didn't have it. You know what I'm saying? They didn't get enough rest. They actually had the longest season. Them and the Miami Heat had the longest season out of everybody that was in the bubble. So they had the least rest out of everybody. And both them and Miami Heat got bounced out the first round. So to me, that kind of means something. That kind of says something. But they didn't have it this year. AD was hurt. It's all good. They're going to be back in the finals next year. They're going to get another chip. LeBron going to get ring number 5. I know Stephen A. said he thinks their chance to win rings is over with because LeBron will be, 36, 37, maybe 38. I don't know how old LeBron is. I know he up there in age, though. But none of that matters. They're going to still win the chip. LeBron still got it. He just got hurt. Like, give my man a break. They're trying to say he old now. Like, he's over with. Like, it's time to hang it up. It is not time to hang it up. LeBron still got game. He can't drive like he used to. He can't jump like he used to. But he still was catching oops off the backboard from Kuzma. Like, nobody seen that? Or I'm sorry, that wasn't Kuzma. That was the Caruso. That was Caruso. He's still catching boards off the backboard. Like, I mean, he's still catching oops off the backboard. Like, this man can still jump out the gym. And now all that happened is his three-point shot got better. He lost a little step, but he still was trying to D-book. They definitely got to strengthen their defense. They got to make some moves. Their roster... it didn't work. I definitely think they should have kept Dwight Howard and Danny Green, but it didn't work out because they wanted so much money. But they're going to have to move that roster around. I say keep Drummond. You got to get rid of Kyle Kuzma at this point. He's just not fitting with them. They could trade him for something. And you got to get rid of Schroeder. Didn't work out. I'm sorry. He wants more money, and he could go kick rocks somewhere. I'm sorry. But it didn't work out with Dennis Schroeder. And yeah, they got to make a couple moves in the offseason. I say try to get Kyle Lowry if they can. I know I might sound like a crazy fan when I say this, but I still want them to get Melo. I do. I would like to see Carmelo and LeBron play together. I feel like Melo would be a great energizer bunny. Like, he could come off the bench, as he already said. He would accept that role, and he would do so much damage right when LeBron is getting ready. Like, that would be perfect. Like Melo could run the, like, second unit, like, pretty much like how Rondo was doing before. Like that could be Melo, in my opinion. That's what Rondo did in the bubble. But that's just my two cents on that. You know what I'm saying? Who I think will win, though, my pick to win the championship for 2021, obviously it's the Nets. Who's going to stop them? Who's going to stop them? And to me, it's so annoying because it's like the big thing was like, oh, nobody's out in the East. Nobody's out East. The East is easy. It's the Eastern Conference. All this, that, and the third. LeBron comes out to the West, and I do believe that the reason why LeBron came out to the West was he would rather lose in, like, the playoffs, in the lower rounds, like the first round or whatever, than to have another like finals L on his record. You know what I'm saying? He didn't want no more finals L's. I think that's why he moved out to the West. So he's thinking he's going to be out in the West playing, whether it's KD, who was on the Warriors at the time, or anybody out here in the West. And then KD run off to Brooklyn with Kyrie. And so it's like, okay, y'all ran off to Brooklyn. Okay. But then this man James Harden going, like, you going to hop on the bandwagon and join him, and then Blake Griffin too. And I'm sorry that LaMarcus Aldridge didn't work out, you know what I'm saying, with his I guess he had a blood vessel or something that was something wrong with his health. But and it was life threatening. But like, that was corny of them. That was corny of them to all hop on the bandwagon and be like, yo, we're going to go get a ring in Brooklyn because we all just going to team up, like, to stop LeBron. We know it's about LeBron. How do we know it's about LeBron? Because he won a championship. Like, these boys base their moves off of how LeBron moves. They see what he does. Oh, he's going out West. Now we're going to go East. Like, that's like, I'm sorry. Y'all wuss for that. Like, y'all scary. Y'all too scary. Y'all literally scary. But anyways, so LeBron got knocked out. The man is hurt. His teammate is hurt. They got knocked out the first round. So y'all get this dub. Brooklyn gets a dub. KD gets another ring. Another, in my opinion, invalidated ring because you keep making it easier. Because I'm not going to say this is his fault because I'll put this on Harden. Harden team hopped to Brooklyn. So I'll put that on Harden. Like, James Harden, you switched teams. That was weak. To if you want to leave Houston, okay, but you went to where, like, you went to where it was hot. Let's be real. And people want to say LeBron did the same thing with Miami Heat. Miami Heat was consistently getting bounced out of the playoffs in the first round. Cleveland was a better team the year before LeBron went to Miami. They went to the Eastern Conference Finals against Boston, and they couldn't get past the big three. So he figured, let me join my man D-Wade in Miami. And then Chris Bosh decided, let's join up, and we'll build a team together. The team was not already good. Brooklyn, I'll say this, though. It is similar with Brooklyn, and but it's not similar with the Warriors. That is not the same. And so I get it if James Harden wants to join Kyrie and KD. I guess it is similar. That is kind of similar to Miami Heat. But I will say this. I think LA going to have something for them boys next year. But definitely, them boys got it in a bag. I'm sorry, I forgot to turn on my 90s hip-hop music. So I'm sitting here talking and it's silent. You know, we got to get the vibes right. Got to get the vibes right. But yeah, so that's just how I feel. So let's keep it moving. Final take on that, the Nets will win the championship. Now, keeping it moving. I want to first give this disclaimer. I am obviously not I am not a financial advisor. This is not financial advice. This is purely for your entertainment. However, I do dibble and dabble in the stock market. I'm learning a little bit. I'm learning as I go, gaining some experience here and there. Something I want to talk to you guys about is the AMC stock. Pretty much that was a crazy thing this week. It was similar to the GameStop short squeeze back in January. I actually lost some money on that, of course, because I didn't know what I was doing. But from that time to from January up to now, I made it my personal business to understand the stock market much more because I lost money on GameStop. So with AMC, I seen that was also a momentum driven stock. Everybody was buying it. It was a short squeeze, but I knew the stock would plummet eventually because people would want to liquidate their money and take their money out. And when everybody does that, the stock goes down, like the money in it. So what I did was hopped in AMC as soon as I seen it go from, it was $9. It was under $10 for the longest. So when I seen it go from $9 to $13 last week, I was like, okay, it's time to get in. So I got in it at $13. And then Friday, it went from, on Thursday, it went from 13 to 19. Then on Friday last week, it went from, this is 2 weeks ago, excuse me. It went from $19 to $30. So then this week, it went crazy in this, it was only 4 days, it was a 4 day week in the stock market because Memorial Day was on Monday. So when I seen that, I'm like, okay, I'm gonna keep writing this up. It's going up. AMC went all the way to 72. Now I got my money out a little early. I seen it hit like, my goal was for it to get to 50. But once I seen it get to 50, it was still going up. So I'm like, I'm gonna keep writing this higher. So once it hit like 61, I was like, all right, I'm gonna liquidate. I'm gonna get my money out before everybody else does. Because the thing is, when a stock is momentum driven like this, it's like musical chairs. You don't want to be the person left when the music stops without a cheer. So pretty much I seen a exit strategy. I pretty much seen it was still going, but I didn't think it was going to go much higher. I didn't see it going to 100 even though I wanted it to. I had 7 shares of that, so I made from 14 to that. I'm not going to do the math, but I know in my head I made close to like $350 off that. So that's a quick, easy little win. You know, that's a little extra pocket change for myself. You know what I'm saying? You know, that's, what is that, like a car payment, you know what I'm saying, for the month? So I took that and that was a little bell for me. You know what I'm saying? But I say that to say this. I think us as black folks in particular, and also all my friends on Facebook, I got people of all different nationalities, but I'm specifically right here talking to black people. We need to get involved in the stock market a little bit more. Maybe not in these momentum driven things, but and once again, this is not advice. This is just my 2 cents and just me giving my opinion. I'm not an expert, but there's a lot of money to be made in the stock market. You know what I'm saying? A lot of us We see something we don't understand and we get scared and just be like, all right, I don't want no parts in that. To me, it seemed like a scam or that's a pyramid scheme or this, that, and the third. And don't get me wrong, I got in the past. I definitely got played before in pyramid schemes, so I understand that. But my thing is this, I'm not afraid to get my feet wet. I'm not afraid to take chances. And you can't be if you want to make wealth. If you want to create generational wealth for your family, you know what I'm saying? There's where there's little risk, there's little reward. So you flip that, you take bigger risks, there's bigger chances of reward. And bigger rewards that come along with that. You know, that's what comes with the territory. So I would like to encourage my culture, my generation, my people, let's get into the stock market. If you don't understand it, you know what I'm saying? There's many books on it. There's many videos on it. I literally learned it from YouTube. Like, YouTube taught me the game. Check out Boyce Watkins. Check out my man Tommy Bryson, Graham Stephan, Andre Geek. Definitely earn your leisure, you know what I'm saying, and the Wall Street Trapper. Check out these different people, you know what I'm saying? YouTube, how to use Robinhood, the Robinhood app. YouTube, how to buy stocks, how to buy shares of stock, you know what I'm saying? You get into this, it's literally like your money that you make from your 9-to-5 job, you throw that in stocks, and then your money that you made, that you put in the stocks, is like an army of dollars making more dollars for you. That's the way I look at it. It's like your money makes money for you. Your money is like a little like army, just like recruiting more dollars. That's the way I look at it. So you know, if those stocks go up, so does your income. And it's passive income. That's what's so dope about it. You ain't gotta lift a finger. But yeah, so that's my little spill on the top stock market. Along with that, I'm gonna give my stock of the week. So my stock of the week is actually Ally Financial. That's a very dope company. I know they give loans. They do multiple things financially. Right now, their stock price is currently, excuse me for a second. So I'm doing good right now, actually. Ally Financial, their stock price right now is $55.30. And yeah, so Ally Financial, let me give a quick brief breakdown on their company. Ally Financial is a holding company which provides digital financial services to consumers. Excuse me for a second. My son just arrived. He was out with his grandmother all day. And here she is again. We actually got 3 viewers. That's dope. Thank you. Hey, Zay Zay, say hi. Oh, dang, I lost my little bit of followers. I mean, viewers. I had 3 viewers, but I had to go pick up my son, y'all. Ah. Alright, go play with them toys right there. See them toys? Alright, so, excuse me for that. I was interrupted. My mom had to drop my son off. You know, life changes when you get kids. You can't just do things you want to do. Sometimes you got to pause things. But anyways, let's get back to the investment talk. So as I was talking, Ally Financial is my favorite stock of the week. Pretty much they're a holding company which provides digital financial services to consumers, businesses, automotive dealers, and corporate clients. It operates through the following segments: automotive finance operations, insurance operations, mortgage finance operations, and corporate finance operations. The automotive finance operation segments offers retail installment sales contracts, loans, and leases, offering long-term loans to dealers, financial dealer floor plans, and other lines of credit to dealers, warehouse lines to companies, fleet financing, provide financing to companies and municipalities for the purchase of lease of vehicle and equipment, vehicle marketing services. So pretty much, Ally Financial, they offer a lot of financial services as far as getting loans for like expensive things like buildings, real estate, vehicles, whether you're leasing a vehicle, buying a vehicle. They're actually the person that I pay my car note to. They gave me a loan for my car. But they're a very dope company. And you look at their 5-year chart, they're really doing well on the up and up, especially the last year. Let's see. So a year ago, if you wanted to get a share of financial, it was $20. Now their stock, as I said, is $55.30. So their 5-year chart says a lot. Your stock is going up. So I definitely recommend getting into them. My crypto of the week is Ethereum. I don't have to say much about Ethereum. Ethereum, in my opinion, the best crypto out. We know Bitcoin is the biggest crypto, but Ethereum is the best as far as use case. People use a lot of Ethereum to buy NFTs, which is like digital art, as you know. So definitely want to get invested in Ethereum. It was actually $4,000 like 3 weeks ago. It's only down to like $2,800 for an Ethereum coin. So if you got the extra bread, definitely throw it in Ethereum. Your investment will flip. Give it a couple years, Ethereum is going to be worth over like $10,000, I believe. Once again, this is not investment advice. This is just my opinion, and this is for entertainment purposes only. So don't sue me if your investments don't work out. All right, let's get into it. And this is the last thing I'm going to say on the stock market. Once again, I also don't endorse doing drugs or drug use at all. But as we know, one of the things going on right now federally is the federal legislation of marijuana. Cannabis, it's about to be legalized federally. And so it's one of those things where it's like you could either be a part of it or have nothing to do with it. You know what I'm saying? I don't like the idea of people getting high, but I like the idea of making money. As we know, weed is about to like go through the roof. It's projected to be about a $70 billion industry. You know what I'm saying? I ain't gonna lie, I want a piece of that. You know what I'm saying? I want a piece of that money. $70 billion, that's a lot of money for our country. And we need that. You know, the economy needs that right now after this pandemic. And so like, to me, when I see $70 billion, I see generational wealth. I want a slice of that pie, I ain't gonna lie. So one big sector to look into for the stock market is the cannabis stock. Once again, I don't endorse doing the drugs. I don't do it myself, but some people need it like medically and stuff. Like my dad, he actually has glaucoma. I'm not mad that he takes his pills that contain cannabis in it, or THC or whatever. So he needs that for his eyes. Some people need marijuana medically, and now it's about to be legalized recreationally. So I mean, you know, it's one of those things where it's different strokes for different folks. In Bible study with V, I'll get into why I don't think you shouldn't take it if you don't need it medically. But, you know what I'm saying? That's just my opinion. However, I'm still trying to make money. You know what I'm saying? And if you're trying to make money, I definitely would recommend getting into the cannabis sector of the stock market. So a couple of those stocks are Tilray, there's Kronos, there's Aurora Cannabis, there's Sundial, and then there's, of course, the index fund for marijuana, the ETF, MJ. So type in MJ on your Robinhood app. It's only like, it's trading at like $21, but this ETF will definitely go up if they federally legislate marijuana, which is coming. It's literally a matter of time. It's not a matter of if, it's a matter of when. So I got a lot of Tilray, I got a ton of Sundial stock, and I definitely got the MJ ETF. So that's just a little of my 2 cents on stocks. Definitely get invested, as I said, Ally Financial, get into the cannabis sector, and just get into the stock market in general, you know what I'm saying? Definitely get into the stock market. That's a quick way to make money. But don't look to get rich quick. Look for the long term. I want to give you this piece of advice. This is something I've seen on one of my favorite shows on YouTube, Earn Your Leisure. If you invest $400 a month into an index fund, something like the SPY, SPY 500, that money will accrue interest over time. And so say you do that $400 a month for 30 years straight, your initial investment of about $190,000, it's a little bit more than that, that will be worth over $351,000 in 30 years. Don't you want to give $350,000 to your child when they're 30 years old? I know I do. I see my son Zay. When he's 32 years old, he's going to have that waiting for him. You know what I'm saying? One of the big things we see, and this is not to knock nobody, you know what I'm saying? We all want the American dream. I grew up seeing my classmates, some of them white, some of them Asian, they're growing up, and their parents, as soon as they turn 18, their parents give them a little piece of that trust fund. I want trust fund money for my kids, you know what I'm saying? Like, and I want to really push that to the black community, because we don't know what it's like to be able to give your child $300,000 when they're like 25 years old, 30 years old, and they're getting their life started. I didn't have that, you know what I'm saying? I'm learning it as I go, but I plan to pass this on to both my generation and the generations after me. You know what I'm saying? I plan on having this whole blueprint, having this whole thing mapped out on how to build wealth for your family. So I want to have that for my children and their children's children, and moving on forward. It's financial literacy. That's what I want to push. So that's my little spill on the stock market and everything. Now we're going to switch gears and talk about movies. So definitely spoiler alert for this. The first thing I'm going to talk about is I seen a trailer for Mike Epps' movie Meet the Blacks 2. It looks really funny. It looks a lot more higher budget than the first one. The first one was a little cheesy, I ain't gonna lie. It was kind of funny. I laughed here and there, but you could tell it was like an independent movie. This one looked like he got like a, I don't know if he got a studio to pick it up or not, but it looks definitely like better made, more money spent on it. Meet the Blacks. And I seen Cat Williams is in it. So I think it's gonna be hilarious. The trailer literally, the preview actually had me laughing. So I hope when it comes out, like, I'll check it out, and I hope it's as funny as the trailer was. I hope, as some comedies do, they put all their best jokes in the trailer, and I hate when that happens. But yeah, I definitely want to check it out. Now, on the topic of Cat Williams, he recently was on the Joe Budden podcast and gave his opinion on cancel culture, and I thought his take was interesting. Now, I'm not going to delve into that really quick, but I definitely would say look up Cat Williams' take on cancel culture. He was on the Joe Budden podcast. Definitely check that out. You know what I'm saying? That's some good content there. Last thing I want to talk about is this Cruella. You know Cruella DeVille from the 101 Dalmatians. So they had her origin story. It's on Disney Plus right now for the premium thing, if you want to pay the money, or you can see it in theaters. It's in theaters. That's what I saw with my wife and my son. I thought the movie was fire. I thought the movie Cruella was fire. I know it might be like a chick flick or whatever. It was a lot of things on fashion and stuff. But I definitely want to recommend checking out the Cruella movie. Once again, spoiler alert. So I'll give y'all a little spoiler of the movie. So pretty much, it goes from when she was a little girl. She had like a split personality disorder, and her name was actually Estella or Estrella or whatever. And so she was like, growing up, it was just her and her mom. And pretty much, they were like living. This was in, it was shot in London. And she was going from school to school because she was bad. Like, she had Cruella, who was her, like, other personality. And she was, like, a bad kid. She was wildin'. And so, pretty much, she goes to this party. Her mom is there, and she's asking for help from this rich woman. And so, the dog start chasing Cruella, the kid. The dog start chasing her through this party. She runs outside to get to her mom. Her mom is like standing on this ledge over a cliff, which is not smart to begin with. But then she like ducks down as dogs are chasing her, Cruella. The dogs hop over her and run to her mom and knock her off the cliff. This is why I say don't stand near ledges. So then Cruella, she runs away and escapes, and she ends up hiding in the middle of like London, and she finds some other kids that are like pickpocketers, and she pretty much grows up with them, and they show her like how they make their money. And so pretty much they become adults, and she always had this like eye for fashion and designing. Once again, this is spoiler alert, so if you're still watching this part, you probably click off if you want to see that Cruella movie. She had an eye for fashion. She just had this talent. And so she gets picked up by the one of this very important people in the city. I forgot the title. But it happened to be the same woman that her mom was talking to when her mom got killed. And so over the span of the movie, Cruella, she's like in her shell as Estrella. And she's like the assistant of this woman, and she makes all these great designs. But then Cruella, as Cruella, her other personality, she competes with this woman, and pretty much she finds out that was actually her real mother, and her mother that died earlier in the movie was just her adopted mother, and she actually was entitled to the wealth of that rich woman. So it's a very interesting story, very great origin story. It makes you feel for Cruella, like you have sympathy for her because she was done dirty. And my son Zay is trying to get into the shot. So say hey to the camera. Nope. Okay. But definitely check out that Cruella movie. I thought it was a very good watch. I'm not going to give away the whole story. I gave away a lot of it, but y'all definitely check it out. It's a very good movie. And I'm sorry if you didn't click off, but I said spoiler alert, so I don't feel bad. So with that, we're going to kind of close this out. We at like almost 50 minutes. Hey, Zay, come here. We're going to close this out. Say hi. Wave to the camera. So pretty much, I got more episodes on the way. I got my man, Paul Cameron, my manager. He's going to be on the podcast next. And then also my wife, Octavia, my brother Vincent. And then I got a couple of episodes. I got a bunch of rappers. I got a couple of girls that are in the modeling and fashion that want to be on. So anybody, if y'all want to be on the podcast, y'all just hit me up. You know what I'm saying? Hit me up in my inbox. Hit my DMs. We're going to get you on here. Penny for Your Thoughts podcast. You know how we do it. We do it big. We get you a penny. You know what I'm saying? Pay you for giving your 2 cents. I don't got a lot of money, so you're not going to get paid coming on here. You're going to get a penny for your thoughts. Literally what the title is. So that's pretty much what we're here to do. We're here to blend people's audiences. You know what I'm saying? I'm trying to build my audience. You know what I'm saying? I know you're trying to build yours. We can put our powers together, put our brands together, and share audiences, you know what I'm saying? Cross audiences. That's my goal. And to give a platform to the people specifically here in the city of Buffalo. And then eventually we're going to branch out like all businesses have to do and go national and then international. So we lit. You know what I'm saying? It's a major movement going on. You know what I'm saying? You could be a part of it or you could just stand on the sidelines and watch it. That's how I'm giving it up. This is a Penny for Your Thoughts podcast. Also, as y'all know, I got music on the way. You know what I'm saying? I was in the studio once this year. We got to get back in the studio with my boy J. Meyer. You know what I'm saying? His production. Shout out to We Make Hits, Tyree and all of them. We're going to get back in the studio this year and get working on that mixtape, Born by the River. That's my mixtape that I'm working on currently. And I got music coming with my brother, Maine, as y'all know. We got a whole album coming out, hopefully next year. But we got a song right now, a cypher that I'm part of. I already finished my verse. I just got to get in the studio and record it. So new music on the way as well. But with that, I'm going to say peace. We at like 50 minutes, right? You ready to go? Want to get some ice cream or something? Get your diaper changed because you stink? All right. Appreciate y'all if y'all checked it out. You know what I'm saying? This is a Penny for Your Thoughts, episode 5 with your boy, Birdell. Peace.